Hi, I'm Sam from Electric Bikes Brisbane, and today I'm going to walk through the Reese & Muller multi-charger, and this one is the GT Touring version. This one is equipped for touring and trekking, really, but what is really unique about this platform is it can do that, but it's also a cargo platform too if you want to use it for that. So in this case, we've got the cargo bags on it. More often than not, our customers will have passenger kits or child kits on it as well as the cargo bikes, so they can carry kids one day, groceries the next, go for a big long ride, and in this case you might even want to go camping or something and carry all your gear and do the rail trail. So there are a lot of different configuration options with the multi-charger, and I'm going to walk through the touring versions. And this one is the version with the derailleur gearing system, and there's actually two. There's a GT Touring and the GT Lite, which both run on a derailleur system. This is the multi-charger, and there's also the multi-charger Mixty, which has the lower step-through frame. What makes it so nimble is that it runs on a 26-inch wheel set. It has got a slightly longer rear rack. So with the multi-charger now, you can opt for two different frame sizes. It only used to be one choice, but now you can get a 47 centimetre or a 51 centimetre if you're a slightly taller rider. And you've got different options in terms of being able to raise or lower your handlebar heights, and obviously you've got the seat heights as well. The difference between the GT Lite and the GT Touring is there's actually not a huge amount of difference. Some subtleties though. So if you opted for the GT Lite, which is the more economical version, you would be getting a Satori suspension seat post versus the Thud Buster. So this is a heavier duty seat post, which will handle rougher riding. Probably the biggest difference is in the drivetrain, where on a GT Lite you'll get a 10-speed drivetrain versus an 11-speed on the GT Touring. They both run on 100mm front forks, so you've got plenty of cushioning at the front, and particularly in this case we've configured this one with the GX, so it's expecting you to go off-road, so you've got like heaps of traction and heaps of comfort at the front there as well. So I'm just going to step you through the configuration on this bike and then talk about your choices if you were looking to configure a bike yourself. So in this case we've gone for the GX option, so this is rolling on off-road tyres, Smart Sams in this case, but you also have the option for the on-road tyres, so the Supermotos, which is just the street tread. Both capable for off-road, but this is more off-road oriented. It comes with the two water bottles, and they sit very handily on your front rack there. It also comes standard with your front carrier now as well. This is the front carrier with bag option that Reese & Muller offer. And there's also a new option this year, which is the cargo front carrier, and that can carry 15 kilos on the front. So particularly if you're carrying, if you are going out somewhere for, you know, overnight or for a longer period of time and you need more carry space, then you've got 15 kilos at the front, and you've also got a really handy 65 kilos at the back. In this particular case, we've gone with a 625 watt hour battery, which gives you your longer range, so again, more thinking about it from a touring perspective. But if you don't need that extra range, you can opt for a 500 watt hour battery, save yourself a little bit of money, and it still gives you plenty of range, particularly if you're sort of more doing your city riding rather than sort of your long distance touring. So you also have the option of configuring it with a second battery for 1125 watt hour capacity if you're thinking about going the extra distance. You've got this really big Ursus kickstand, so it's a very wide stand, very stable. In this particular case, we've configured this bike with the Nion display. You have a lot of choices with displays from a configuration perspective. If you want to keep the costs down, you could just opt for a Purion display. You've also got the smartphone hub or the Nion, as we've put on here. All multi-chargers are powered by the Gen 4 Bosch CX platform. So we've got the Gen 4 CX motor and this nice handy little charge port just here where you can just charge on bike. Of course you can take your battery out too if you want to charge it off the bike. So all multi-chargers come configured with a wheel lock, an AXA wheel lock. You can choose to also add the additional chain lock. It sits really neatly under the seat here. Continuing to move down the bike, we've got this lovely big long rack here, great for carrying all sorts of stuff. In this case, we've put the Reese & Muller cargo bags on here. So these are great, they're 33 litres each side and heaps of room inside. We've got dogs being carried in here, it's really cute. You can also choose to put a passenger kit on here instead, or there's also the safety bar kit if you've got younger children. But really handy range of options for accessories with this to turn it into a really useful bike for you. So it's not just for fun, it can be really functional for your everyday life as well. So this is a bike which also comes fully equipped, which means you know, you've got your mud guards, and these are really wide mud guards, so keep you nice and clean, keep your cargo clean as well. Really comfortable grips as well, and then nice integrated lights. So these are the Supernova lights. A top choice if you're looking sort of for that real SUV of the e-bike world. If you would like some further information or you'd like some assistance with the configuration, there is a lot to go through. We're very happy to help you. Jump onto our website on the Contact Us page. You can send us an email, chat, or give us a call. Very happy to help you.